Hello everyone, welcome to School World. This video we are going to discuss class 8 science chapter 1 part 3 of the chapter crop production and management. This is the index of School World. This channel is made for helping all by making them understand hard concepts and solving sums. School World also has a quiz. There are three sections, section A for understanding, B for solving questions, and C for quizzes. Step 4. Irrigation. What is irrigation? Irrigation is the process of supplying water to all the crops in the field. Nutrients are also absorbed by the water and reach to the plants. Some sources of water for irrigations are wells, ponds, lakes, canals, tube wells, and even dams. Water moistens the soil and thus softens it so the roots can penetrate inside very easily. There are different conditions in different seasons, like in summer, crops require higher rate of water, and in winter, crops require lesser rate of water. Next is methods of irrigation. There are two types of methods of irrigation, which are traditional methods. In traditional method, the irrigation is done manually. Here, the farmer pulls out water from wells or canals by himself or using cattle and carries to farming fields. The only advantage of this method is that it is cheap, but it is very time consuming and it is only used by poor farmers. Some examples of traditional methods are pulley system, lever system, chain pump, and Delkey. Methods of irrigation. Modern method of irrigation. The modern method of irrigation compensates the disadvantage of traditional methods and thus help in proper way of water usage. Some of the modern method involves two systems, which is sprinkler system and drip irrigation. Let's first talk about sprinkler system. A sprinkler system, as the name suggests, the water is sprinkled all over the crop like the rain. And it is used in the areas where there is water scarcity, so the water can reach to large area. And the second point in this sprinkler system is that there is a nozzle above the pipe, so due to the pressure the water goes very far. Second is the drip irrigation. In drip irrigation, there are pipelines situated at the roots, near the roots of the plants. So drop by drop, the water reaches to the roots. And this method is used in the regions where water is available very less. Now, types of irrigation. First one is Delkey. Delkey refers to traditional irrigation practice in which water is drawn from nearby well using pulleys and then spread on the field. And in this method, the wastage of water is very more. Then the next comes is Rahat, and Rahat is based on lever system, and water is received from a well by using oxen. It requires large well with a wheel which is turned by animals. Next is moat or pulley system. It is based on pulley system, and moat is a deep white ditch that is filled with water around the walls. Next is chain pump. Chain pump is based on pumps. The pumps consists of a pipe connected to water supply and a circular chain and flat platters. Then these platters are connected to main chain, which is drawn up through pipe, and the water is caught on platter and brought to the surface. Next is sprinkle irrigation, which is used in agricultural crops, lawns, landscapes, golf courses, and other areas. And they are also used for cooling and control airborne dust. During summers, the land is very dry, so when vehicles pass through the roads and nearby areas, the dust rises. Then at that time also sprinkler irrigation is used. And in sprinkler irrigation, water wastage is also controlled. The last comes the drip irrigation. Drip irrigation is also called micro drip irrigation, because it uses very less water, and it is also called as the less water wastage irrigation method. And it drop by drop the water reaches to the root of the plant, and it also रिमूव्स द वाटर वेस्टेज. दिस आर सम पिक्चर्स ऑफ इरिगेशन. Now, advantages of irrigation. First advantage, irrigation makes it possible to grow cash crops. Second one, it improves the groundwater storage as water lost due to seepage adds to groundwater storage. So, during rainy season, the water seeps inside the ground and this storage is called groundwater storage. But due to evaporation, this water is lost. But irrigation supplies the water to the plant. And it also improves the yields of the crops, and we use it to help growth of plants during the period of not enough rainfall. Like I said, when groundwater storage is very less, and water helps in absorption of minerals from the soil, so minerals come along with the water to the plant. Water protects plants from frost and hot dry currents. During summers there are hot and dry currents from which also water protects, and from freezing also. And irrigation helps in translocation and ascent of sap. In ascent of sap also, water is transported from up to down, from roots to the leaves. In that also it helps, and in translocation of food also. Now, sources of water. There are various sources of water. About 97% of water on Earth's surface is covered with water. The three main sources of water are, first is rainwater, second is groundwater, and groundwater includes bodies like wells and springs, etc. And third is the surface water. This includes different water bodies like sea, ocean, reservoirs, rivers, streams, ponds, lakes, and tanks. Thank you for watching School World. Like and subscribe. We will come up with new content in future.